Hello, everybody. My name is Invicta, and welcome back to Library of Runa. Today, we're going to be picking up a little bit after where we left off at the end of the last episode. We're still looking for more key pages and cards and stuff. Now, some people have been talking about you can upgrade or update the key pages, and I'm not exactly sure how to do that, because as far as I know, these stats are fixed. So unless if I'm missing something, yeah. But obviously, I haven't been doing any of the passive attribution here, but Team Husky, Team NL need a lot of help on their end. So we're also going to be today going for the Book of ? I think that these are for the random invitations. I could be wrong about that. But I do want to say, first off, thank you all very much for the continued support here on Library of Runa. And yeah, now I tried to record last night and my computer overheated during a fight, so I don't think I got credit for that. But one thing that I did do was I did a single book invitation, and I got a completely different encounter. Now, people have been saying that you don't have to put all three books in here for the invitation. And that's what I did. So I just did a single book here, and we end up unlocking something. So we're just going to start here with Team NL and find out, although they are kind of underleveled for this. I wonder what happens if we put two in there. This is just the same thing. Yeah, so we can either put the Book of Hanafuda or the Book of Jiang Office Fixer. I think this is the one that we need to unlock. That's what I'm assuming this lock is. So yeah, we'll find out. Okay, yeah, so this is the same team that I came across last night. These guys are all based around bleeding, and they self-inflict their bleeds. Now the grunts here, they're not too bad. But the next page has a boss in it, and that's when my computer overheated. So we'll see. I haven't looked at Husky and Malku's deck or NL's deck in a while. So hopefully they can manage this, but we'll find out. All right, gonna turn quick mode off. Now, people were also saying that you can look at the cards and you can determine whether or not what order it's going to be blocking for. I don't know exactly what they're talking about. I think Show Clashes was one. So both of these are coming after Husky. They're gonna be acting, this one's gonna be acting first, obviously. So it's got a 3-6 and then 3-5. So I'm not sure if the Show Clashes was here, but I'm gonna have Husky skitter away on this one. And let's see if it shows it on here. Yeah, so the arrows, I think the yellow arrows are supposed to show, I think, where the attacks are going. I think that's what the clashes are representing. But anyway, because obviously I'm still learning as far as like what goes in the order of operations and whatnot. NL, we're gonna have him just brawl here. Doesn't really matter what we do. So this shows that NL will be intercepting this one here, and then Malkuth is gonna have a one-on-one against this Rusted Chainlink, who's just doing 3-6, 3-5. So we're just gonna do Rampage there. Then NL doesn't have anything else, so that's it. Rolled a 4. Husky got the 6 on the dodge. 2. He got counter deflected. Then rolled a 1. Good job, Husky. 7 for Malkuth. Got the deflect. Retaliate. Gets 8 and 4. Then NL did draw the brawl. Got a 7, an 8, and a 3. All right. Happy memories. Combat page. The highest cost in the hand is chosen. Using this page of the same name will decrease the cost. Sure. We'll use that on NL. Why are you trying to leave me? We're such good friends. Okay, so again, we're going to go for Brawl here. Let's see. The 3. Let's go for... Yeah, I know he can basically only do one thing, so we'll just go there. Husky's got to deal with a 3-7 and 2. That's an odd choice. We could go for another retaliate. Yeah, I'll just do another retaliate here. He might be able to win that clash in the first evade. And Malku, 3-7, 3-6. 4 to 5 sounds good. 7 got the 6 on there. Deflected the 5 and then got a 3. Oof. Malkuth getting destroyed there. And now at the brawl, a 6 and a 6 and an 8. No surprise, NL is doing the best because he does have the most developed deck here. Okay, so we want... This is kind of a bad... This is a bad draw for NL. Yeah, basically, that's all he can do. 4 to 12. Shocking blow there. Let's see, Husky... Husky can go for Rampage, or we can just give ourselves Endurance to that. Husky needs, we need to improve these decks here. Then Malkuth can actually intercept this one, the Rusted Chain Link. There's no bleeds on this target, so Cruelty actually wouldn't be a bad counter deck for these guys. Let's go for that one. Max damage there on the 5, got deflected, no problem. Shocking Blow, parried there. And Malkuth still struggling. Upon winning clash, deal bonus stagger damage equal to the dice value at a 20% chance. Or ashes. When hit, inflict 1 to 3 burn to the attacker. Gain a buff with 40% chance the next scene. Offensive die, inflict 1 burn on hit, does not stack. Let's go for upon winning a clash. We'll give this to, I guess just give it to NL. NL's kind of out of light, though. And he's got no light. He's got no light regeneration, so... Just kind of like a remnant of how out of date these decks are. 5-1-5. Husky can't really intervene here. He's gonna hit on the back end of that, and then NL can't do anything here. 3-4. Good job by Malkuth. Taking a 6, almost staggered, and Husky gets the deflect. All right. This isn't a great chance for Brawl here. I doubt we're gonna get scratched that on here, but we'll see. Husky can intervene here. Or it could go for Mutilate. He's not really missing too much much HP, but there's not really much else he can do. He can also attack on the back end of this, I think. Or we could just go for the stagger here. Let's go for the stagger here. So this is actually, so these two are actually going to clash here because Husky is faster than NL. So NL's gonna get a free hit on this one. I think that's what this arrow means. I think that's what the yellow arrow means. The 5 there, good job in Malkuth. Still 1 on the stagger. Yeah, so Husky's clashing first. Husky getting the nice stagger. A 9 on that one. Oof, Malkuth in a lot of trouble. And he did draw a scratch that. Wow. NL with the big time plays. One to 15 here. Husky's got to deal with that. We can go for dodge and strike, or go for law and order, or we could just go for the gusto here. All right, so we've been able to protect Malkuth for now. 4 got a 3-4. Hard to blow. Wow, got a 9 on the shocking blow. They're both going for Malkuth because they're trying to kill her. Malkuth is going to have to... Oh, frontal dodge. Okay, so that one's actually not a big deal. Could try to go for that. Maybe she'll win the clash. Then Husky. Husky and NL. So Husky's going to be the one to clash with this Rusted Chain Link, but Malkuth and this one are gonna go first. 5 got a 3. Yeah, that's what I figured. So here comes NL walking in with a 12 big max damage there. And Husky ended up losing. Oh man, now they both get speed die because they're maximum motion. That's not good. It's not good at all. We need to get them out of here. And L can't, he literally cannot do anything. One to five, one to six. Let's just try to deflect this. I think Malku is pretty much dead here. Unless Husky can get the stun. Hey, he got the stagger. Almost got the kill as well. Yeah, down goes Malkuth. When a librarian's HP is at 20% or lower, deal 30% of the target's max damage. Then die. Well, we can't really do anything about that. So we basically cannot... We cannot lose more than 30% of our HP, basically, is what that means. Yeah, that's not good. Here we go. We're gonna go all out here. And Husky just has to roll a 2 on this, and so that one's dead. There we go. Husky got that one. 8 on that, a 3, and a 7. Wow, look how much light this one dude has. They're not messing around here. Motion level 4. And L can't do anything. And L is defenseless on this attack here. Yeah, he didn't take that much damage. Tally and Husky did not get the stagger. That's not good. Husky's bleeding. On winning clash, deal bonus stagger damage. He's got to win the clash. So go for destructive impact there. Husky's got to deal with that. And he got stagger deflected. And he only got a 4 on that roll, but we did get the stagger. But it's just down to NL right now. And we're going to get out of there, but woof, that was rough. That was rough. All right, here's the boss, Jakan. I don't think they're going to be able to handle this, so we're gonna have to bring in the ringers here. We bring in Mathis, Team Baynard, or do we go to our A team and bring out Roland, Sinvicta, and Little Daisy? Let's bring out the A team. We don't want to lose to these guys. Sorry, Team Baynard. We gotta win this. She's so cute. All right, everyone going for Little Daisy. Not sure if that's what you want to do, game. 3-7, 3-6. Everyone coming after Little Daisy. All right, so let's see if we can, me and Roland can give her a little bit of backup here. I can intervene on this behalf here. Actually, no, I can't. Daisy's faster than I am. Roland can intervene on this one. Okay, so Sakura is not going to work here, but Flash or Sunup will. And we can also get Flip the Table. Or just go for Sparking Spear. Okay, so Roland's actually going to clash here. Daisy's not. That's fine. Daisy rolled a 2 on the evade. Wow, 7 damage on that one. And then Daisy only gets a 4 on the retaliate. Uncontested hit on her second die because I didn't adjust her attack. Roland rolls a 1, and then I get a 9. All right. And Roland's going to intervene. It's a 7 on the max roll, a 5. Here comes little Daisy with the high-speed stabbing. All right, not the greatest rolls there, I gotta say, but we almost staggered the boss, so. All right, I'm up first. I can really only do a weight up, so Roland, you wanna help out here? 1 to 5, 4 to 7. So Roland can do a shuffle. Four plus pages, discard a random page and boost minimum value of this of the offensive die here. All right, so Roland's going to go there. He's not clashing with this? That doesn't make sense. I guess because they're not directly going after each other. Well, then I'm going to clash there. Then Roland still has that. I think we're going to wait because we want to boost the offensive die there. Then little Daisy's got to deal with these two jokers here. So she can actually win this one. And then she doesn't have enough life for the other one. So hopefully she doesn't get staggered here. Hey, I got the weight up. Here comes Sakura. Got a 5 max damage there. Wow, rolled a 10 on Daisy. Daisy rolled a 9. But max rolls, of course, from the AI. We could go pulsation here. I think it's a little bit too risky. We can give Daisy some more speed. Or we can go pale hands here. Pulsation worries me. Daisy needs a little bit more HP, but we can also get 3 to 10 bonus stagger damage. Let's keep it simple and give Daisy the speed. Oh, she is now staggered. So that gave her 5 HP. I rolled a 9. All right, so me and Roland are going to be able to help Daisy here. And then Roland. We can discard or shuffle hands. I think we gotta go to stay calm. Yeah, we'll just do shuffle hands here. Lots of clashing. Of course he rolled an 8. Oh, and he rolled a 10. Oh, and he rolled a 9. Okay. All right. Must be nice, computer, to get all max rolls whenever you want them at all times. There we go. Finally get the stagger on Jakan. I got the 6. The Library of Runa just getting all the max rolls literally whenever it wants. Because that's what happens when you have RNG. We need to get Jakan out of here. We're gonna go daring decision here. This is a risk, but we need to get him out of here. Okay, little Daisy's back. 3 to 6, 3 to 5. can go for a transpierce here. Then that frees me to do whatever I want. Go there, and then we can get a free burn on you. Job by Daisy. Good job by Daisy, winning both her clashes. Roland going in for the dunk on Jakun. Got a 12 from little Daisy. Got the stagger. Oh, man. Daisy. Now an emotion level 3 here for the other team, and that's not good. Not good for them. So Daisy can act first here. And we're just going to... I'm going to intercept the clash here. That's fine. One and two. Good job, Daisy. There's the stagger. Little Daisy going in for the wake up. Or wait up, whatever. Grab brush, put a little makeup. All right. A-Team gets the Dunkerino on Team Jakun. Good job to Team Husky, though. So just staying in there, staying alive. Ooh, look at all these books. No battle symbols gained. No battle symbols gained. All right. All right. Oh, we got the... Was that the book that we needed down here? It was not the book that we needed. We have no idea what book we need for Team Malkuth, Husky, and NL. But we can burn some books, though. We got 3 books of... We got a whole lot of chain link. And maybe we'll get Jakun's page, maybe. Let's see if Team NL can get lucky here. They definitely need some upgrades. Hey, let's go. We got one of them. Inflict 1 bleed on self next scene. See, I don't understand. To me, that seems counterintuitive because you're basically hurting yourself. Dice gain 1 power for every 5 stacks of bleed on self. That's like straight up like Berserker. For every 5 stacks of bleed. You get one damage, plus 1 damage to enemies with bleed. Deal plus 1 damage to enemy with bleed. I mean, these pages are better than what we have for Team NL. Like NL's got the only, he's got the only good key page, but his brawl deck needs work. His brawl deck definitely needs work. We can still stick with a brawl deck on him, but I need to give him card draw, and I need to give him light recovery. So we need Flash of Sun Up. There's nothing that gives us card draw there. We're out of Flash of Sun Ups, I think. Oh, no, we have 2 that are unequipped. Yeah, so there's our card draw for NL. And then light recovery. On use, inflict 1 bleed on self, next scene restore 1 light, so that's also a free one. Outburst is also not bad. I don't like the idea of giving himself bleed. I can go for outburst. One outburst there. Okay, so NL's good. NL's got that worked out. Okay, Husky. It's time to upgrade Husky here. Do we give Husky Jakan's page? We'll let Husky be the berserker. Oh god. Okay. All right, let's try the, we can try the bleed. Sure. Click one bleed next scene on hit. Click three bleed to self. All dice on this page gain two power. Flank attack. He does get two die, right? Yeah, he gains one speed die, so. No bleeds over here? No, there's gotta be other bleeds over here, right? Yeah, I was gonna say. On hit, bleed. Remember HP equal, yeah, cruelty, that's the one I was looking for. That one seems like it's okay for HP regeneration. Look, two bleed. Gut harvesting still good. I like going first. I don't think Rampage is that great for this. Two bleed there. Three to six, three to five. We'll try one of those. We'll call this a... Okay, so Husky's good. We need to do the passive attribution real quick. And we can't get anything out of there. Pierce damage. Anything with bleed. All these are basically the same. Pierce, what kind of attacks are those? These are slash and blunt damage. Oh, there's Pierce. I have a couple Pierces, but this is mainly slashing damage. So maybe we want to look for slash. Slash stagger damage 2. Slash stagger damage 1. 50% chance to boost the slash damage. Okay. We got two left. We can stack these? Didn't know that. Okay. Then we just need one more. Paralysis. Here's damage plus 1. I can't fit it in there. Sure. Oh no, we flat out just can't fit anymore. That's fine. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, so we do that. NL needs his passive attributions fixed here. He could go for slash damage along with that stuff. So we'll say, yeah, this would go well with that'd go well with Husky's passives. Lone Fixer, and then slash stagger. Cover 1 HP upon winning a clash. Say 50% chance to boost slash damage by 1. Okay, so Husky and NL are good. Malkuth's page needs a lot of help as well. Let's get Malkuth a much needed upgrade. Which one do we want to give Malkuth? Should give Malkuth that one. We have pierce damage here from Pamelli's page. We'll give her a quick pierce deck. There we go. Open wound. I like the idea of those two stacking with the rest of the team here. Your stagger damage. I like it. 50% chance to boost pierce damage by 1. Okay, the Malkuth needs piercing attacks. So we'll say yeah. All right. Retaliate's just too dang good. We want mostly piercing damage. Collision's real good. I do like Transpierce. With Paralysis. Sparking for a little bit of card draw. Paralysis. And a wait up. Okay, I think that I think that Team Husky is good. We'll do one more fight here. See if we can get the Book of... Not the Book of Jakan. Nope. Hanafuda. Oh, there we go. We don't know this one. Ordinary Grade Fixer. There's only one act here. But these guys don't look anything special, so this would be a good opportunity for us to test out our new decks. Go there. Three, six, three, five. Cruelty is going to go first. We don't want. We can let Husky rest on that one. And then Malkuth. Actually, Malkuth can go first. She's going to clash. And instead. You like that? That's right. I learned how to recall the attacks. I bet that's surprising. So we want Husky to go first there and then use cruelty. There we go. I'm learning the arrows. Yay! Let's turn on quick mode. Dub by an elm. Max damage to Malkuth. There's Husky getting the bleeds. Oh my god. Oh my god, Husky. Good lord. What were those attacks? Well, I think Husky can just go do that and then take a rest. Let's see. We can intervene here. And that frees up NL. Go for a wait up. They go for a brawl. Husky's just going to get the absolute dunk of a lifetime there. Oh, man. NL did draw brawl here. Good lord. I'd say that's a pretty good... That is a pretty good deck improvement for everyone here. Yeah, we're just gonna clash there. We're just gonna go ham here. We can go for a collision. Actually, no, collision didn't make sense. I guess a wait up. And Husky. Let's see here. Husky's got that. Yep, there we go. All right. Head to head. Oh my gosh. Husky's just destroying people. Look at that. And now coming up from behind. Oh man. Well, would you look at that? We made some improvements to our decks. And we got a new book that we've never gotten before. So, all right, everyone. Well, that was a very productive, very, very good round of Library of Runa there. So, again, I'd love to see these videos get 1,000 likes. We have yet to have one go over 1K, except for the first episode. So, if you want to see continue seeing this series on the main channel here, make sure you're clicking the like button and leaving a comment down below. I really would appreciate everyone. Thank you very much for the continued support on Library of Runa. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.